Hi everyone, today in this video I am going to solve how to find the particular integral when right hand side is x raised to m, that is x to the power m. So to find the particular integral of x raised to m. So to find the particular integral of x raised to m, first step we have write down, that is 1 divided by f of g of x raised to m. So this is particular integral of x raised to m. F of d is nothing but an equation containing d. Okay. First step. Write denominator terms in ascending order. Ascending order means from lower to larger value. Second, you have to take the lowest degree term. Take lowest degree term of d form. Means you have to take the lowest degree term outside in denominator. Third, you have to transpose this denominator in numerator. Transpose. So first I will tell you example so that you will come to know. Let us say, suppose there is a equation d square plus 2d plus 4 of x raised to 3. First you have to write down in the ascending order denominator, that is 4 plus 2d plus d square, that is from lower to higher. Then you can take the lowest degree term outside. What is the lowest degree term? Here lowest degree term is 4 because coefficient is d raised to 0. Therefore you can take the lowest degree term outside. If you take 4 outside, we are left with 1 plus 2 divided by 4 is equal to 1 by 2d plus d square divided by 4. If you divide by here 4, you will get, or better you can write 2d divided by 4. 2 by 4 is equal to 1 by 4. Say this is one bracket and this is another bracket. So this is of the form 1 plus phi of d. Sometimes you will get minus sign. So denominator is in the form of 1 plus or minus phi of d. You have to transpose this 1 plus phi of d in numerator. Transpose 1 plus phi of d in numerator, you will get 1 plus phi of d raised to minus 1. Sometimes you will get minus sign also. Then 4. Expand 1 plus phi of d or minus d raised to minus 1 by binomial expansion. So there we can make use of some formulas. So I will write here, remember, one minus x raised to minus 1 is equal to 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube and plus and so on. This is the binomial expansion of 1 minus x raised to minus 1. What is 1 plus x raised to minus 1? 1 plus x raised to minus 1, you will get alternating sign. 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus and so on. Similarly, 1 minus x raised to minus 2. There you will get 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube plus and so on. And 1 plus x rest 2 minus 2. You will get alternating sign. Same. 1 minus 2x plus 3x square minus 4x cube plus n. So, by using this formula, you have expand 1 plus pi of d raised to minus 1 or 1 minus pi of d raised to minus 1. And then fifth, operate on. Operate on x raised to m. This is the method to find the particular integral when right hand side is x raised to m. I will repeat once again. From denominator, or first you have to write down the denominator terms in ascending order from lower to higher. Then from denominator, you can take the lowest degree term of d outside, that is common. The power of d should be 0. Sorry, that is lowest. You have to take common. And then that will be in the form of 1 plus pi of d or 1 minus pi of d. You have transposing numerator, you will get 1 plus pi of d raised to minus 1 or 1 minus pi of d raised to minus 1. You have expand this by using these formulas and then operate on x raised to m. Now you can take examples. Solve 2b square plus 5d plus 2, bracket complete y, 5 plus 2x. So here the power of x is 1, so which is of the form x raised to m. So to solve this, first I will take the left hand side, that is auxiliary equation is, what is auxiliary equation? 2m square plus 5m plus 2 is equal to 0, which is a quadratic equation. So 2 into 2 is equal to 4. Find the two factors to get plus 5 means 4 into 1. So we can write it as 2m square plus 4m plus m plus 2 is equal to 0. From first two terms, you can take 2m common. If you take here 2m common, here we are left with m plus. And from 4m, if you take 2m common, we are left with 2. And from last two terms, you can take plus 1 common, that is m plus 2 is equal to 0. So 2m plus 1 into m plus 2. M plus 2 is equal to 0. So 2m plus 1 is equal to 0. M plus 2 is equal to 0. Here m you will get minus 1 by 2. Here m you will get minus 2. Therefore, complementary function is equal to c1 e raised to minus 1 by 2 into x plus c2 e raised to minus 2 into x. This is complementary function. Now, you come to the right hand side, 5 plus 2x. So, we have to find the particular integral of 5 plus 2x, where the power of x is 1. So, in such cases, particular integral of 5 plus 2x. So, to find the particular integral, we can write 1 divided by f of d. What is f of d? 2d square plus 5d plus 2. That is 2d square plus 5d plus 2. 5 plus 2x. So, to solve better, you can write in the increasing order. Increasing order means better I will write 1 divided by 2 plus 5d plus 2d square of 5 plus 2x. So, it is very easy to find the lowest degree term. So the lowest degree term is 2 because the power of d is equal to 0. You can take the lowest degree term outside. That is 1 divided by, if we take 2 outside, here we are left with 1 plus. From the second term, you cannot take 2 common, so there divide 5 divided by 2 into d plus. From the third term, you can take 2 outside, So we are left with d square. So this term is nothing but 5. So here you will get 5 plus 2. This is equal to, I will write 1 by 2 as it is. Transpose this denominator term in numerator. You will get 1 plus 5 of d is nothing but 5 by 2 into d plus d square. Rest to minus. If you transpose the denominator term in numerator, you will get 1 plus 5 by 2d plus d square rest to minus 1. And the remaining term is 5 plus 2x. This is equal to 1 by 2. This is equal to 1 by 2 into bracket. So first I will write here complementary function. C1 e raised to minus 1 by 2x plus C2 e raised to minus 2x. And now I will write that is equal to 1 by 2. You have to expand this by using binomial expansion. So which is of the form 1 plus x raised to minus 1. And whenever you will get plus, there you will get alternating sign. And its formula is 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on. So what you will get, that is 1 minus. What is x? This is x value. X is equal to 5 by 2 into d plus d square. 5 by 2 into d plus d square. This is x plus x square. 5 by 2 into d plus d square whole square. Minus and so. And bracket complete of 5 plus 2x. Now we have to expand this or operate on this 5 plus 2x. How much we will get? This is equal to 1 by 2 into bracket. 1 into this 5 plus 2x is 5 plus 2x. Next here, minus into 5 by 2 into d is minus 5 by 2 into d, so that is minus 5 by 2 into d. Of this 5 plus 2x means differentiation of 5 plus 2x. Differentiation of 5 is 0, differentiation of 2x is 2. I have written this minus 5 by 2 as it is. Differentiation of this 5 plus 2x is 2. Next, minus into d square is minus d square. D square of this 5 plus 2x means second differentiation of 5 plus 2x. First differentiation is 2. And what is second differentiation? Second differentiation is 0. Means the power of d is greater than the power of x. Then you will get differentiation 0. So here a plus b whole square formula. A square. A square means d square. Differentiation will be 0. B square. B square means d raised to 4. Differentiation will be 0. And plus 2ab means where you will get a into b, b into d square is d cube, where the power of d is greater than the power of x means there also you will get differentiation 0 and so on. The remaining terms all you will get 0 of 5 plus 2x. Sorry, this is as it is. One by two, 5 plus 2x minus 5 by 2 into 2 minus 0. Where 2 and 2 get cancelled. So 1 divided by 2 into bracket. 2x, this plus 5 and minus 5 get cancelled. So at last you will get 2 and 2 get cancelled. You will get x. Therefore, complementary function, sorry, complete solution. Complete solution is equal to CF plus PR. And CF, y is equal to CF is C1 e raised to minus 1 by 2x plus C2 e raised to minus 2x plus particular integral is x. This is the required solution. Thank you.